A big reason I decided to become a medical technologist was that in college I loved everything to do with microscopy, which is working with microscopes. Using the microscopes to look at bacteria and living things that we can't see with the naked eye just is really exciting to me, and I get to use that almost every night in my job here. It's thrilling, and I love that part of my job. My key responsibilities are receiving and analyzing blood specimen and body fluids. I run all the tests myself and report back to the nurses and doctors, give them the levels and the results that they need to treat the patient, and make sure all my instruments are working correctly. Maintenance is very important, so I do maintenance every single night before I start running the actual patient tests. I also check on the shift before me to make sure that they don't need any help when I first come in. Then I just receive the specimen that come from the floor. There are stats, which are specimen that need to be resulted right away. And there are also routines, which are specimen that, you know, can be done after the stats. All the results are important to be done as quickly and efficiently as possible. It's very important to give accurate results to the nurses and doctors for many reasons. First of all, because that's what they are using to treat these people. They're using their levels, their different chemical balances, their blood counts. They're using everything that I give them to treat them. So it's very important to give them correct numbers. It's very important that my instruments are working correctly. That's why maintenance is important. Doing controls is very important. We need to make sure everything's falling in the right ranges. That way the patients are also falling in the right ranges. For example, if I gave a doctor or nurse a result that was too high on a patient, they could treat them to make their level lower, when in reality their level might have been normal, and that's very harmful to a patient. To become a medical technologist, you need a four-year bachelor degree and then a one-year clinical year in an accredited school. You can do that a few different ways. The path I chose, I received my bachelor's degree, my bachelor in biology, and then I pursued the one-year clinical rotation, and I did that locally here. Another avenue is some colleges have a CLS program, a clinical laboratory science program, where you can do your first 3 years, and then your fourth year of college actually becomes your clinical, and that kind of makes it a little bit shorter. If you're interested in becoming a medical technologist and you're in middle school or high school, I would recommend taking a lot of science courses. I would recommend taking maybe some chemistry, even though that's not wasn't my favorite in school. You still have to take it, and you have to understand what you're doing. I also always recommend to friends that I know that have children in high school to take a maybe post-secondary option if your school has the option of taking college courses while still in high school. That's very beneficial to you. And another thing I would recommend is maybe going to a laboratory and shadowing there. That will tell you in one day, 1 hour even, if this is what you want to be doing with your life. So I highly recommend that.
Hi, it's Amanda from lab. I have a critical for you guys.
I prefer to be one step away from actual patient care because I'm a very compassionate person, and I've dealt with a lot of things in life, but I don't like to see that. You know, people are sick and hurting, and, you know, caring for them takes a lot and takes a very special person to actually physically care for them. I help in a different way. I, you know, report to those nurses and doctors that are caring for the patient firsthand. The thing I love most about my job is that no 2 days are ever the same. There's always different problems to be solved. Sometimes it's different problems with the instruments. Sometimes it's problems with patients. It's very exciting, and I don't want to be doing the same thing every single day. I think that's a little bit boring, so I love my job.